So we'll see I'm on top of this particular segment, but we're going to need to buy a small break. By the time we come back, we'll get another guest. We'll go enter inside the building. Stay with us. All right, yes, and welcome back to the Balanced Diet of Teletainment this morning. Right now, we don't enter another segment in a very serious matter because according to reports, 150,000 children, whether they're born for inside Nigeria, they actually get sickle cell disease. Now, on June 19, the day they actually set aside, according to the United Nations, to celebrate or to create awareness on top of sickle cell disease and the disadvantage and the advantages or the way to manage this sickness. But today we don't bring out this particular doctor where she said Na Sabinus on top of this profession and she go choke mouth on top of sickle cell disease for inside Nigeria. Help me make welcome Dr. Jesupelumi Adenihu inside the studio. Good morning.
Good morning.
Welcome. Thank you very much, Doctor. And you, they represent the Sickle Cell Aid Foundation for Inside Weobodo Ninja here. Now, first of all, I just want to ask, because we know there are different campaigns on ground talking about sickle cell, the dangers of sickle cell, how it is very important for you to know your genotype before you actually marry. Why be say even till now, we still get a high rate of people dying from sickle cell, despite the advice where we know the medical profession has done the dish out?
Thank you very much for having me here. So first of all, it's still surprising that people actually still present with sickle cell. So I may still refer to it as people not being aware enough, or maybe people are just aware and then they just choose to be negligent about it. So usually most times, you know, this is even the Valentine's period and there's a lot of emotions, butterflies everywhere. So people sometimes throw caution to the wind and then they don't take adequate steps that are supposed to do. Like just the simple basic thing of knowing your genotype. You know, I find few people now, it's not even about your level of literacy or education, but there are still people I meet and then they don't know their genotype. Or they'll tell you, oh, I checked some time back and it was different or something. So they're not really clear about their genotype. And, you know, this goes a long way in actually telling or defining the kind of children you're going to have or even the kind of person you should even settle down with in the first place or say yes to. So I would say ignorance and then maybe people negligence to sometimes.
Look, we won't start from the very beginning in terms of sickle cell disease.
Yeah.
What is the sickle cell disease and what is the genotype all about?
Okay, so the sickle cell disease, that's like a broad name categorically. So, you know, the normal human cells, the blood cells, they're round. But when you see the sickle cell has a sickle or crescent shape. And usually when someone comes down with that type of disease, like usually they need to have two of a sickle genotype for them to say they have sickle cell anemia. But then sickle cell disease is a broad term for anybody that carries like the S gene, that's the sickle gene. So for example, someone may have AS, another person may have SC, another person may have SS. So the SS, we define that one as the anemia. But the disease generally defines when someone carries the S trait. So when someone comes down with sickle cell anemia, that's when you find it difficult that you commonly hear terms like, okay, this person has had a crisis, and then they have to be rushed to the hospital. Sometimes they have breathing difficulties. Sometimes you even find them with swollen hands and feet. So it's a crisis, like it affects all of the organs because, you know, when blood is not getting to a particular part of the body, and then that system begins to break down. So from the head to the toe, there are different manifestations of sickle cell disease.
I don't hear cases of people coming out to say, oh, yes, I'm AS, and this other person is AS. No worry, now only one picking out you go born, where you go be SS. The rest should be AS and AS.
That is not true. Mm-hmm. Okay, so there's a probability tree that we can draw. You know, if, okay, so just the way you have your husband, and then, you know, you donate one gene to your child, and then your husband would also donate the other gene to the child. So now when we talk about the probabilities, we're not saying for every child, we're not saying that, okay, this one child will have AS. It's not definitive. You know, it's a probability. Mm. So if a couple is AS and then the other couple is AS, it means for every child they get, there's a 50% chance that they may get a child that is AS, or like one in two chance that they may get a child that is AS, or one in four that they may get a child that is SS. So it's not particularly about saying, okay, that this child that will born is going to be AA or AS. It's a probability. So one over four chance that that child might be SS, one over four chance that that child might be AA. So it's not like...
So it's even fixed. Dangerous for AS and AS to marry?
Yes, it is.
We not say they're quite dangerous, and we not say technology don't reach, it don't advance to a certain level where the crisis they fit to manage them.
Yes.
But for this part of the world where we believe in, enter a risky situation and take your problem to the altar.
Yeah.
And pray for a miracle.
Miracle, yeah.
And if a miracle finally happens, you go to church and testify to encourage others to also partake. So if you can see and say a cycle where if you know one story, if you know one person will actually be will get success story on top of them, is an encouragement for you to want to venture into it. I get close friends where they actually know the consequences, but they are still considering doing it. They're still considering getting married and bringing children that might have this crisis. Waiting with you to tell those kind of people, what are those myths that we need to debunk on top of the sickle cell situation?
Okay, so first, I always tell people, like personally and even amongst my friends, I'll tell them one man's experience is not the experience of another person. So the fact that one person has already gone through it and then person possibly had a child that didn't come out with sickle cell does not mean that will be the same story for you. Like we said, it's a probability.
But they'll pray on to make their case, that one.
But I think it's about still informing them, because the truth is, people are adults. So you can encourage or you can advise, but you can't force or enforce the decision on them. It's still theirs to make. I have a friend who, like, I was actually very proud and actually impressed. So both of them, they realized they were AS. We're into the relationship already, but still she had to like step back because she was aware of the consequences. Because the truth is, when this thing comes, when a child has sickle cell, apart from the cost effects, now I'm talking about cost, not even the financial cost alone, but even the emotional side effects, and then the strain it causes on the child, on the parents, the repeated visits to the hospital. You know, many times you look at it and actually really sit and ask yourself, is it worth it? And even being in this part of the world, being even in Nigeria, this part of Africa, can people afford the cost of care that is involved or that is necessary for that particular child? So as much as possible, I think we still also need to just keep telling and then advising. That's the best thing we can do, because people in the end still make their own decisions.
So what's the way forward for those living with sickle cell? Now, we know say research don't advance.
Yes.
In America, they do the bone marrow transplant.
Yes.
What about in Nigeria?
So in Nigeria, I know recently is it Benin Teaching Hospital or if I'm correct now? So they started doing the bone marrow transplants, and the last conference I went for, I know he spoke about having three success stories.
Wow.
But then he actually complained about the cost that was involved, because it requires electricity, there are lots of things involved, it has to be in a sterile environment, and then he spoke about the challenges. But can it be done? Yes, it can. But then have we really gotten to the stage where we say we can do lots of it to address the population of people that have sickle cell in Nigeria? I wouldn't say we have gotten to that point yet. So maybe when we get there in future, but as at now, not yet. So now basically what we just do is just encourage them to have their regular hospital visits, and then as much as possible, like, family support is important. And then even the basic things, like them staying hydrated, they can do exercises. You know, sickle cell disease, yes. Let me just say this. They can still live their lives, like...
Normal lives.
Mm-hmm. So it's not a... How do I put it now? It's not a spell, or it's not a stigma
for the
them.
End of their lives.
Exactly, or the end of their lives. So I've seen people that, okay, they get pregnant, sickle cell patients, of course, but then, you know, they have to get married to people with AA. So they get married, get pregnant, have their children. And in few cases, you have people living up to 60, 70 years. But then it's not always the case as it may be. So they can still live their normal lives, but then they have to be in check, visit the hospital regularly, ensure they stay away from things that may predispose them to coming down with malaria, stay hydrated, get their medications, the vaccines that they ought to get it at the appropriate time. So it's... more for them, it's better to prevent any crisis than for you to have to treat. So their regular checkup is necessary.
Now, for this part of the world where if you're a sickle cell carrier, like me, I'd be AS, and I know people know say I'd be AS. In those days, I used to rebuke. I said, God forbid.
Are you serious?
Of all the children where my mama be born, three of us, and I knew one of us was AS, but I just didn't think it had to be me.
Okay.
And then when I can't discover her, I can't be like saying a course.
No.
But it took me a while for me to acknowledge and to overcome all of that. I can't get picking when I AS, as we speak. And as I tell when I get the report, the way they send them, I be the fear. As I tell, I give it to the child, they send me the report. I can't the one that say, carrier, what happened? Is it not just AS? It's not like I'm a sickle or something. Yeah. So are they bring this one up because we need to know at what point in the relationship should you discuss genotype issues? Some people they wait to when they don't carry belle.
Okay. Wow.
That's when they discover
always
that they actually
when they don't.
So at what point in the relationship do you discuss or do you advise that they discuss, couples discuss about genotype?
Okay. Since we're talking to people that are still single and still intending. So I'd best advise that it's good for you to know from the beginning, from the word go. Because
even when sometimes the relationship might not be a serious one.
It's
even
better, my sister.
Just good to know. I always say because some people might enter a relationship and say, you know what, it's just a fling, nothing serious.
No, it's better to know.
Like I always, that one, the first question where they always ask.
Exactly. So you just, you know, even amongst some friends, they would joke and say, now part of the questions is what's the genotype, so that we'll know before we even go midway.
So in my own situation, doctor, they asked me what my genotype was. I said I was AA.
Are you serious?
Nah, man. It's when I went to the hospital to do checkup. So I go three hospitals too, because I did not believe I was AS. So in that kind of situation, like me now, where if you ask me, I go first cup, I be AA. When I went to the first hospital, they told me, listen to my sentence. So nobody saying I wait till I get. I call say they tell me saying I AS. So no mind there, no this year hospital. They don't get equipment. Wow. I went to the second one.
Okay.
They tell me again, say I'll be AS. I said, 90% can come to me and say, no, actually, if you've gone to two hospitals and they've confirmed it, you are AS.
You'll be there in denial.
Yes.
Not that you got a round.
Even before I went to do the tests.
And so because I assumed
I was always an AA. So a lot of people, they in that same assumption, say they're actually AA because to them, they don't see any reason why they would even think of being AMAS.
So if they actually get that particular perception, say they've been AA without even going
to exactly. Check.
And that's why I like when you come outside talk, say one of the most things where everybody needs to do.
Yeah.
You don't even need to be in a relationship for you to know your genotype. It's very, very important for you to know your genotype.
Yeah.
Now, apart from, I know there is AA, there is AS.
Yes.
I guess there's another one again.
There's SC, yes. So there's even AC, but those ones are rare.
Okay.
So those are like the less common ones. Okay. So for them, it won't be as magnified as the SS.
Okay.
So they may have few symptoms, maybe tiredness, and then for some of them, they have large spleens, but it's not marked as SS. So, yes. Yeah. But people like that, they still, so if you see someone that has SC now, so it's still part of the genotypes. So it's not only AA or AS or SS that we have. Those ones still exist, but they're not as common as
now. My last question: you get one myth where they talk say people will get AS are more prone to malaria, as people with AA. How true is this?
No, it's actually even the other way.
They
say the AS is protective of malaria. That's why the sickle gene is still existent even in Africa, because we are the ones carrying malaria now. Every month, people treat malaria. So the S gene.
Why
confers,
is it? Why?
That's it's a tropical that's, zone.
Yes, yeah, so that's
we are prone to malaria.
Yeah. So it confers protection for malaria.
So you see, there's a plus, yes.
Well, to it. Oh!
Because I'm
okay,
AS.
Okay, encourage yourself. Yeah, there's nothing wrong with actually being AS. There's absolutely nothing wrong with being AS. So that's it. And then I just wanted to point out something, because you spoke about going to the hospital to check, and then you were the one that had the idea that you were AA.
Mm-hmm.
But for some people, it's possible that they may have gone, and then, you know, we shouldn't also overlook it. It's possible to have a wrong report.
Yes.
So in that case, what would I advise? I'll say, okay, just get it checked again and again.
Yeah.
So if it's that you went to an hospital and then the first one was AA, the next one was AS. So you just get a third opinion, and then which one would it be? That's better for you to be able to actually confirm what your genotype is. Because even for me, I had to, like, mine was even my blood group. I was like, but this was not my blood group. Well, that was not what they recorded for me some time ago. And then I went back and then I had to check and then saw that it was actually the correct thing. So,
Thank you very much. So you're interested in how to talk more concerning sickle cell anemia and how to prevent your children from actually getting them. So please, we beg you today, not just rely on God can heal everything. Yes, we believe in God. Yes. Trust us. Yes. But they're very important. God don't give us wisdom. They're very important. Say you go know your genotype and make the wise decision, not just for you, but for your future kids. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
To enjoy more of this, our Ogonge videos when you just watch, press this button to subscribe on top of our YouTube page. You go love her.